look around at the world today. People living life so afraid of the headlines and the evening news.
And things grow dark, no hope, losing heart. Yeah, they're all worried, but here's the truth.
This morning. Good way to start the service off, is it not? Good to see everyone today. Got a good crowd outside, many of you in here, and we welcome you this morning. And if you're visiting with us, you're certainly our special guest, and we're glad that you've come to worship with us at Poplar Grove. Let me share with you just a couple things. Men's ministry in the morning. We gather around 8 o'clock and have Bible study from 8:30 till about a little after 9, and we certainly invite you men to come be a part of that. We have great crowds on Monday. And Kathy Mills went to Lexington this past week and brought back a big can of gravy. So we're going to have that tomorrow to get rid of it. So we're going to have gravy and biscuits, guys, in the morning. So that's always a thrill for all of us. My doctor just told me the other day that I need to start eating more gravy, and I'm glad it worked out this way. So we got that. We got Tuesday. You got the ladies' ministry. Always a great time. The ladies gather together, a wonderful crowd of them. They do a lot of things for our church. And of course, Wednesday night, we're back in here now. Awana's kicked off again a few weeks ago, and it's picking up every week, and we want to get back to where we once were. And so you bring your child Wednesday night, and then while they're in there, you can come in here and have a time of Bible study with us. So there's a lot of things going on here at Poplar Grove that we need to be a part of. The bunny hop, we're going to do that again this year for Easter. Some of you remember that. It's like trunk or treat, except it's a bunny hop. So they need to start getting ready to bring candy and stuff. Is that right? All right. Miss Marv's our children director, and so we're going to do that this year and look forward to not long till Easter. You know, time is just moving right along, and springtime will be here in just, 25 more days or so we'll be having spring, and I always look forward to that. But I'm glad you've gathered here with us this morning, and so Chad's going to come now, our worship leader, and lead us, please.
Well, good morning. Let's all stand this morning. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus, no, not one, as we sing the first, third, and fourth stanza.
Troubles pass.
As we go to the Lord in prayer, there's several we certainly need to remember. First of all, I want to share with you, recently Chad McCullough lost his mom. She passed away, and he wants to thank the church for the expression of kindness and the prayers and all that were lifted up for him during that time. Also, this past week, we had the funeral for Billy Dean White, Miss Glenna's husband, many, many years, and she would like to express to the church, and I'll hang these up out on the bulletin board, thank you for all the love and the support that's lifted up for her during some trying days, and we need to remember both of these families in the days ahead with the passing of one they love. Let me share with you some folks that we certainly need to remember. Herman Adams, Jr., continued to lift him up. Glenn Baker, Ronnie Blevins, preacher Ronnie Blevins, some of you know him. Glenda Bray, Lauren Dameron, Donnie and Wanda Eaton. Donnie's back at home now and certainly needs our prayers, so remember Donnie and Wanda both in your prayers. Cassandra Estep, Chris Farmer, Linda Ferris, remember Miss Linda if you would. Johnny Fox, Pat and Earl Fox as well. Meredith Gaddis, Sue Gibbs, doing much better, and we rejoice with that. Richard Hicks, remember that family. Wes has gone to Indiana this weekend to bury his brother-in-law, who just suddenly died. Just fine one day, and the next day his life was over. And so remember that entire family, if you would, in your prayers. Margaret Hopkins, Matthew Ivey, June Johnson, Adriana Jones, Laura Kennedy. I got a note from her husband, and Laura has been having some more health issues and certainly needs our prayers. Remember Miss Vicky, and actually on the web you can get her address. She's at Victor's house. If you would like to send her a card, I know that would mean very much to her as she goes through her time of treatment for her cancer. So remember Miss Vicky, if you would, and you can express your condolences or your love for her through a card would be nice. Carol Inhart, Steve Mahoney, Paul's brother, needs our prayers. Bill McKinn had some surgery this past week, and he's doing okay from that. I spoke to him a couple times. So remember Ozine in your prayers. Marie Edwards, Delmar Mills, Jean Pryor. I had a good conversation this week with Miss Jean. She is so upbeat about everything, and she's a great lady of faith. And we talked a long time. We just I enjoyed our conversation. She's encouraging, I'll tell you. So remember Miss Jean, if you would. Lane Rice, a young boy. Leon Barton. Paige Saylor. Mrs. Gary Shields. Frida Simpson is doing good. She's back home now recovering, and we rejoice with that. Rose Smith. Gail Sprinkles, Bruce Hooker is now home from the hospital. Renee's husband, we rejoice with that. Jamie Taylor, Rhonda, our piano player, is back with us. She's doing good, and we're certainly glad of that. Also, Mary Ann Vanover, a new name added to our list. In the hospital, Bonnie Mills is in the healthcare facility now out of the hospital. Joyce Horn, we need to continue to remember her. Cole Moore, a little 9-year-old. Violet Kinney, 7 months old. Several we need to remember. As a church family, of course, I remember the Hobbs family. That service was this week as well. Wayne Hobbs, who attended here with us and until his health gave away. We had his funeral this past week. And also, Billy Deans was on the first of the week, and so a member of the White family, and as you pray, George Collins family, and then Bobby Kaiser, who would be connected to the Hicks family, remember them. Also, Stacy Roark family. We got a lot of folks, a lot of people that we are remembering in prayer. Billy Graham's son, whom I enjoy, Franklin Graham, I enjoy his messages and I enjoy his thoughts. He's asking that all the churches across the land pray today. We've got a bad situation going on with Ukraine over there, and there sadly there are many are losing their lives. And Those people are the most courageous people I believe I've ever seen. Little ladies up in their 70s and 80s who are willing to go out and stand against equipment coming through town to stop it and to ask for a weapon. They'd rather lose their life than some young person. So they're courageous people, and they're battling, but they need our prayers. They certainly need our prayers. This whole world's in such a mess. So much hatred in our world, things going on. We don't understand why. But God is still on the throne. We got to remember that. And so let's pray that he will intervene perhaps there and can stop this bloodshed and useless people dying uselessly. No reason for it. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for prayer. And Father, we come to you now with the thoughts from Psalm 46 that Mr. Graham shared, and that God is our refuge and our strength. He's a very present help in time of trouble. Lord, we know this world's in trouble today. Our nation's in trouble. This whole world we live in, there's just so much going on, and a nation rising up against nation. But Father, when we study our Bible, we see it's nothing but prophecy being fulfilled. So Lord, I just pray for those people over there that they could sit down some way and negotiate something and to stop all this bloodshed and useless deaths, people dying, and the life over, young folks, older folks. It's just a sad time. So we join other churches across our land today in praying for this situation. And Father, we pray for our church family. We have many people in our church family who are sick or in the hospital, or family members are sick. And God, we know that you know every situation, and we're praying that you'll intervene is what we're praying for. And Father, we pray especially for Glenna and her family, and for Chad and his family, and Wes and these others who've had the passing of someone they love so much. I know it's a difficult time, but we're reminded what the psalmist said. He said, "Be still and know that I'm God." So God, we know that you're on the throne today, that you're still in charge. You know everything that's going on in this world today, and nothing surprises you. So we're just praying, Father, that you'll move your hand upon these families, upon these people who are dealing with health issues, upon these families who have lost loved ones, and then upon our nation, Father, and then our world. God, we're praying that you will do that you will make yourself known. And I pray this in Christ's name. Amen.
I'll stand this morning. Here I am to worship, Light of the World. Light of the world,
will you step down into darkness? Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you.
Here I am.
Here I am to
full of sin when Jesus found me. All my heart was full of misery and woe. Jesus placed his strong and loving arms around me, and he led me in the way I ought to go. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one else could take the sin and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cares.
Sing that chorus again. No one ever cared for me.
No one ever.